Today I'll be using this 2000 watt continuous wave laser cleaning machine by Fortune Laser to clean various different samples of steel. And I'll be using this machine at its full scan width of 300 millimeters. That's about 12 inches for my American viewers, because when you're cleaning large pieces of metal, time is money.
All right, first we're gonna clean this section of channel here. And over here, the settings we have 50 scanning frequency, 50 hertz, and a 300 scan width. And we're going to be doing all this at peak power of 2000. And there's what it looks like after about one pass. I think it went over a couple times over here. On this side, I'll do a higher frequency just to give you a comparison of the 100 hertz versus the 50 hertz. 100 hertz. And here is that 100 hertz. Still does have a little bit of etching, a little bit different of a texture. I'll flip this over and we'll do this side at 150 millimeters scan width, just to see if we get any different kind of texture left on the surface. And we'll do this side at 100 hertz, 150 millimeters. And here's a close look at those. You can see this side has a little bit more of the etching than the 100 hertz does. But in this case, because this surface wasn't that really corroded or pitted, having that power, 2000 watts, spread out over the 300 millimeters versus the 150 millimeters didn't seem to make a difference. Next, we'll do this piece here, which just has a lot of dirt and debris on the surface, tiny bit of mill scale. And the backside of this one is actually pretty clean, but we'll do it too. And again, we're gonna start with 50 hertz at 300 millimeters. Now I'm going to do this half at 100 hertz, still 300 millimeter scan width. And looking here at the surface, you can see 100 hertz side a little bit, actually a lot smoother than the 50 hertz. And this stuff here brushes off my thumb. Same with anything left over on this side. And now we'll do the same test on the opposite side, which is already pretty clean. And here's a close look at that one. There really wasn't much to take off there. You saw the laser wasn't really having to work that hard. Now we're gonna try this one. It has some very, very light surface rust. So that was 50, and this is gonna be 100. I'm just doing one pass on this because the whole point of this is to save you time. So I imagine you're not going to be scanning this a bunch of times over and over. And here's what we've got. 50 and 100. I can see a slight hint of some of the rust still on the 100. You can see some of these stripes going horizontally here. And that's just where the laser wasn't quite on the metal long enough. So I'm gonna flip this over and do the same on the other side, but I'll spend a little bit more time. And here's how the second side looks. You can see it's a little bit brighter, a little bit shinier. It wasn't quite as rusty to begin with, but spending that extra time on it with the laser really did brighten up the surface a lot compared to the other side, which was just one kind of quick pass. And this will be an interesting one. It's got very heavy rust hitting, and we'll try it at 300, and then we'll try it at a smaller skiing width if we need to, just to concentrate that power over a smaller area. And this is going to be 50 hertz at 300 millimeters. And I'm not going to put the whole beam on there because this piece is small. This is 100 hertz. All right, this one's a little hard to read. This surface was really rough, and you can see I did 50 hertz over here, 100 hertz over here. Did one pass overall, then I went back and I did a few more passes on the outer edges. So that's four passes, one pass, and four passes. And I really can't tell too much of a difference between the multiple passes. What I am gonna do is try, because I still have some rust down here, I'm gonna go down to a lower hertz frequency and see if I can blast off any of this surface rust left here. Because if I get a chisel, it looks like there is still a little bit of rust under on the surface just because there was some very slight scaling. Same on this side. So when you have this kind of situation, you're either gonna need to decrease the beam width to concentrate that power and really get through all that rust and scaling in the surface. Or we can try a lower frequency and see if we can etch a little bit deeper. And I'll try that first, because I know the whole point of this is to save time and speed. So we'll keep it at 300 and we'll do 30 hertz. Now I'll just do this down here at the bottom. And here is 30 hertz. You can see it actually brightened it up a little bit more of aggressive of a setting here. And let's try the scrape test. And it looks like we did get all the way through the scaling down to clean metal. All right, for this one, because this is really heavy rust here, I'm gonna go with a scanning width of 100 millimeters at 50 hertz just to compare what the shorter scan width does compared to a lower frequency.
And we'll do the left side, same 100 millimeter scan width. We're gonna do this one at 30 hertz. Okay, we got 30 on the left, 50 on the right, and you can see when I scraped it, both sides did have some material on the surface that came off. There's really not much of a difference, maybe slightly heavier etching on the left side, but there really isn't much, I'd say barely any spots on the side where there was any surface rust under what I scraped off. This side, same, maybe slightly more than the left side. So that makes sense because you've got a more aggressive setting over here, which is going to get down deeper and sort of remove more of that surface imperfections. And if you look really close, you'll be able to see this in the actual samples, maybe not on video. There is a little bit more mill scale on the right side than there is on the left side. And it's real close. Next up, we have this long piece here. This is pretty clean steel on both sides. So we'll do this with 100 hertz and see what we get. And we're gonna go full scan width at 300. Well, to my surprise, there was actually a coating on there that came off not as well as I expected with the 100 hertz. You see it sort of got some of it in other places, not so much. So we'll flip it over and do the same test at 50 hertz. Here's a good comparison of 50 hertz versus 100 hertz. You can see how much more aggressive that 50 was, even though it wasn't quite aggressive enough. For some reason, the laser, I don't know, just doesn't really know what to do with this kind of surface. I don't know if it's because it's already so smooth and there's not much for it to remove, but I'll go ahead and try this again at 30 hertz just for comparison. All right, here is 30 hertz on the end here. All right, 30 hertz. It did do some more etching, but the surface is still really rough as far as not removing all that coating that was on there. So I'm gonna try one more test. We'll try it down on this end. We're doing 50 hertz. We'll do 100 millimeters, and we'll concentrate that power in a smaller area and see if that makes a difference. All right, here is 100 hertz, 100 millimeters, 50 hertz. What I do, like I think one or two passes here, and I did probably 8 to 10 passes on this side. And yeah, it's just a resilient coating. Laser cleaner has a little bit of trouble on that one. And you'll see in the sample, it looks smooth, but if I scrape my thumbnail on it, it's still pretty rough. Thank you. This will be an interesting one because we've got some couple different textures here in the surface. We've got some welds that need cleaned up. So we'll do 50 at 300 and go from there. Here's how it looks close up. Same with a little bit of the same issue we had with the last cleaning. This gray here, it just seemed to have trouble getting that off. And over here on this side, just for fun, we'll try 100 hertz. I don't think it's gonna do any better than the 50 hertz, but it'd be a good experiment. Here on this backside, we'll do a 100 scan width at 50 hertz. And this row is going to be 30 hertz. In this last one, we'll do 100 millimeters at 100 hertz. And here's a comparison of all three of those. Kind of hard to tell on camera. This one's a little bit smoother than this one here.